Hi, thank you for watching this video. This video is about medium chain fatty acids and triglycerides, the power of virgin coconut oil. My name is Jonas, brought to you by Virgin Coconut Oil Malaysia. Okay, now first of all, medium chain fatty acids, what are they? Now, medium chain fatty acids are the components which make the virgin coconut oil and coconut oil powerful. That's what gives them the power, okay, over other oils, over other fats. Now, the medium chain fatty acids are essentially a group of fatty acids with chain, okay, the fat is a chain of 8 to 12 carbon atoms. I'll go into a bit more in just a while, okay. So the virgin coconut oil or the coconut oil contains three medium chain fatty acids, namely caprylic acid, capric acid, and lauric acid. If you look at the diagram on the right, you know, the first one is caprylic acid. If you count the C, which is the carbon atom, it's actually a C8 chain, okay? The capric acid, there is C10, okay? There's 10 carbon there. And the lauric acid, actually C12, okay? There are 12 carbons. So these are the three medium chain fatty acids contained in the coconut oil or the virgin coconut oil. Now let's talk a bit more about medium chain triglycerides and medium chain fatty acids. I just mentioned that the three medium chain fatty acids contained in the coconut oil. But the medium chain fatty acids, or this caprylic, capric, and lauric acids, do not exist as individual fatty acids in the virgin coconut oil or the coconut oil. Okay, in fact, the form of which they exist is known as medium chain triglycerides. Okay, short form we call them MCT. Okay, the medium chain fatty acids is MCFAs. Okay, now triglycerides are essentially three fatty acids of similar length joined together through a molecule known as glycerol. The tri stand for three, okay? So actually they are three fatty acids joined together by a backbone or a foundation called glycerol. If you look at this diagram a bit more detail, okay? Now, these are the three fatty acids. By the way, these are, I believe, they are long chain. I think they are more than 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, yeah. These are long chain fatty acids. So there are three long chain fatty acids joined together by a backbone, okay, by some bonding mechanism, and that molecule, the backbone molecule, is a glycerol, okay. I'm using this diagram and just took it off the internet. In fact, this is actually called long chain triglycerides. But if, let's say, the carbon here, let's say C8 and so on, that would be a medium chain triglycerides, okay, or a C12, the 12 carbon here, 12 carbon here, 12 carbon here, that would be a medium chain triglycerides, okay. So again, the triglycerides are categorized into three types, namely short chain, medium chain, and long chain triglycerides. I know this is a bit technical, but we need to understand that, because I need to explain the active components or the active ingredients that is working to give the benefits in the virgin coconut oil or the coconut oil. Okay, now, so when we say fats and oils, we are essentially talking about triglycerides. You know, if you have done any blood tests, if you look closely at the blood profile, under the blood category profile, you will see an item called triglycerides. Okay, triglycerides are essentially, you know, things, the fats that are in our food, okay, and they could be short chain or medium chain or long chain fatty acids, you know, the spare tire in our stomach or in our thigh or under our arms, all these are triglycerides, okay. These are triglycerides. In other words, the fats that we consumed, depending on what type of fats, okay, most of them are converted into triglycerides and stored, things like that, the spare tire, you know, and under your thigh, you know, and whatnot. Okay, so when we consume fats, the triglycerides are broken down, okay, and then these individual fatty acids are released, okay. So when we take virgin coconut oil, we are actually taking the medium chain triglycerides, we are taking the MCT. Now, when it enters, when we take it, it starts breaking down in the mouth. through the saliva, and then the stomach, and then they break down into their individual fatty acids, namely caprylic acid, capric acid, and the lauric acids. Okay, so this is a very important point. They only change when you eat it. So that's why, you know, when the coconut, you know, because the power comes from the medium chain fatty acids, not the medium chain triglycerides. Okay, the medium chain triglycerides do not have any effect, okay, until they're broken down. That's why when the coconut oil, if you let it sit there for a while, you'll spoil, because they are still in the form of medium chain triglycerides. They are not in the form of medium chain fatty acids. But if they exist as medium chain fatty acids, it's a different story. It will not spoil, okay? Now, let's talk a bit about what I mean by that. What's so special about the medium chain fatty acids, okay? One of the most powerful effects of medium chain fatty acids is the ability to prevent and cure infectious disease. That's the key, to prevent and cure infectious disease, okay? Because of this, they are used in skin lotions, okay, cosmetic products, dietary supplements, and many over-the-counter antibacterial, antifungal, and antiviral medications. Take note of that, okay? Medication. The medical world has long known about this, okay? And they're using it in a lot of medications, okay? They have been using it in hospital for a long time, you know, for premature baby, for the elderly, for the critically ill, okay? Because the MCFA is actually, in terms of the anti-infection, there are four properties, okay? Antibacteria, antiviral, antifungal, and antiparasitic, okay? Parasitic is a parasite, so things like worms and things like that. Antibacterial, in other words, you know, if you're taking antibiotics, this is what we are talking about. It's like a natural antibiotics. Antifungal, you know, things like yeast infections, it's quite common, you know. Anytime when you get virus infection, the bacteria will start growing, the fungus also. These are opportunistic, you know, microbes, okay? Now, antiviral, not too many substances in nature that possess this property, okay? Only a few, okay? And coconut is one of them. And coconut is probably the most abundant of it, okay? If you remember one of the ingredients, you know, let's go back a bit now. We mentioned about lauric acid. In fact, when they first found the medium chain fatty acids, it was from a seed known as laurel seed, okay? And I believe that is how they named this acid, lauric acid. And laurel seed actually contains about 37% of the medium chain fatty acids, which is quite high among all the different oils. But coconut oil contains close to 50%, okay? 50% of the medium chain fatty acids, and therefore it is the most abundant source. I think palm oil also quite high, okay? Now, again, it's used in many applications, and it's just that it's not been publicized. I mean, in the medical world, it has been using it, you know? Okay, so actually MCFA is one of the most widely used substances in food processing. For what? To prevent spoilage, because they are antibacterial, antifungal. So they've been used it. But of course, the industry itself, the food industry, replaces this with vegetable oil and whatnot. If you don't know what I'm talking about, you look up another article that I wrote, another video that I, where I talk about the history of the coconut oil. The title of the video is called, "Is Coconut Oil Good for You? The Truth About Coconut Oil." It's a very ugly history, but I believe everybody, you know, I feel that everybody should know about it. And from there, we start to understand, you know, what is so great about virgin coconut oil and coconut oil, okay? Now, let's talk a bit about MCFAs and mother's milk. Medium chain fatty acids and mother's milk. This is one of the most exciting topic and most important topic, okay? And the next video that I'm going to produce will be solely on this topic. And I think all the young couples, mother who are expecting, mother who are breastfeeding, I really encourage you to watch the video. I'll touch briefly on here because this is not the topic of that particular. Now, science have already found out that mother's milk contains medium chain fatty acids, okay? And through the research, they realize that this medium chain fatty acids actually play a very important role to protect the baby from all the germs and microbes the moment they are born, okay? Because when they are born, their system is still not mature. Their defense mechanism is not fully in place. But Mother Nature actually gave them the weapon, which is MCFAs. And because of this, in fact, nowadays, most of the modern milk formula contain MCFAs. Some form of MCFA, either as lauric acid or monolaurin. You try to check on it, okay? One of those ingredients are in there, in most of the good ones. They try to mimic, you know, the mother's milk. And in the mother's milk, one of the most powerful component is MCFAs, okay? The medium chain fatty acids. Okay, so again, as I mentioned, this is very important, especially in the baby's first year of life, when his or her immune system is still immature and very vulnerable to attack by all these germs and all these bugs, you know, that is surrounding him or her. Okay, now another idea, again, you know, please, if you are really interested in good health, the mother, for yourself and for the baby, please watch out for my next video and next article, okay? Don't get me wrong, okay? Virgin coconut is for everybody. But that particular post really drilled in on why mothers, expecting mothers and breastfeeding mother should be taking virgin coconut oil. I wished I have known this before my son was born, okay? But still, I'm giving him right now because it still will benefit him, which I'll talk about in some other articles and videos. Now, the next item is MCFAs enhance blood circulation. Okay, so research has shown that the medium chain fatty acids actually stimulate metabolism. Okay, and if you eat a meal that contain medium chain fatty acids, such as coconut, okay, the metabolism can actually increase up to 65%, and that is very, very significant increase, okay? What does that mean? You know, increased metabolism means what?
Excuse me.
Increased metabolism will lead to increase in blood flow. So what? Increase in blood flow, what does that do? Okay, increase in blood flow will in turn increase the oxygen supplies to the cell, okay? So people who are taking virgin coconut oil and coconut oil, very likely they'll feel an increase in energy level. And that increase in energy level is because of the increase in metabolism, which leads to increase in blood circulation, which increase in oxygen supply. That's why there is a feel of it, more energetic and more alert, okay? Now, reap the benefits of MCFA by taking virgin coconut oil, okay? So the best way to get this benefit of the medium chain fatty acids is to take the virgin coconut oil as dietary supplement. What that means is that actually, you know, the virgin coconut oils are being sold today. Actually, you can pour it in a spoon and just eat like that. It may sound a bit gross or sound a bit unusual, but if you try it, it's actually very nice. I've been doing that now, okay? So it's nice, actually. It's very nice, okay? Now, I would go as far as to say that throw away all your other oils, okay? Which is what I've done. Throw away, replace them with coconut and virgin coconut oil, okay? For cooking, you can just use normal coconut oil. But for dietary supplement and for, you know, really as a supplement, you should take virgin coconut oil, okay? Now, we can talk a lot about the technical aspects, chemistry and whatnot, but to get the benefits, you don't need to know this, honestly. Try it, okay? Try it, and the rest doesn't matter, okay? The technical aspects, chemical chemistry, it's just for further understanding, okay? For those who still sternly believe or been led to believe that virgin coconut oil will cause heart problems, that is totally propaganda, that is wrong, okay? In fact, the chances of getting heart problems from the current non-coconut oil that you're eating are very, very high, okay? That's why I would go as far as throw away all the other oils, okay? Just a bit about history. In fact, if you ask anybody in the health field or in the nutritionist, if they tell you that they said coconut oil is not good for you, don't blame them, okay? Because when I was at the university studying agriculture, it was in the late '80s, okay, late '80s. We were taught canola oil is the best oil because it has the highest polyunsaturated fats, okay, and animal fat is bad for you, and because of the saturated fats, and that is true, okay, and we'll go into another details, but the saturated fats in the virgin coconut oil is different. It's not the same saturated fat as you found in animals, okay. The medium chain fatty acids in the coconut oil is actually protect your heart. It's not harmful to your heart. So we cannot generalize by saying saturated fat is bad for your heart. Yes, there are some very, very bad saturated fats, but not the saturated fats, which are the medium chain fatty acids in the coconut oil. Okay? If you talk about the butter, there's about 3%. In general, there's about 3% of medium chain fatty acids in the butter. Margarine shortening, out the window. That's going to kill you, okay? In the long run, it's bad for your heart. It's going to do a lot of damage to heart-related things, okay? So, but anyway, we'll talk more in future videos. And I hope you really, especially for the mothers, you know, who are expecting young couples and breastfeeding, I hope you will watch the upcoming video, Virgin Coconut and Baby. I may name it differently, virgin coconut oil and mother and whatnot, okay? So once again, thank you for watching this video. I hope the information here will help you in one way or another. Thank you. Bye-bye.